night and day, under the hide of me, there's an oh such a hungry yearning burning inside of me, and its torment won't be through till you let me spend my life making love to you day and night, night and day.
This movie wins an Oscar for the song, The Continental. It also receives an Academy Award nomination for Best Picture. Venetian blinds become popular because of this movie.
On November 14, 1934, at age 23, Ginger marries Lou Ayres. On November 28, Ruby stars in Flirtation Walk.
Well?
I'm your aide, General.
My aide to what?
Your aide de camp, General.
Well, we aren't going camping for a while.
No, General.
Lieutenant Quibble, you're a very personable young man.
Thank you, sir. Ma'am. General.
Do you happen to be engaged or married or anything?
No, General.
Ah. In that case, consider yourself semi-engaged to me. It'll make things so much simpler.
Thank you very much, General.
Who's that?
A private, General.
A private? Oh, that's too bad. I must have you promoted.
Thank you, ma'am.
is from the academic board. They ask for a conference with you, General.
Who are they?
Well, they're the army officers who run the academy, General.
Tell them they're fired. Tell them to go back to the army where they belong.
But, General...
Now, no protest. Don't start presuming just because you happen to be semi-engaged to me.
But, General, without the academic board, how will we discipline the cadets?
There isn't going to be any more discipline. Those nice cadets are starved for beauty and a woman's touch. And they're going to get it.
The regimental commander, sir.
Show him in.
Regimental commander?
That must be the cadet complaints, General.
Good. I've always been in sympathy with cadet complaints. You can go away for a while, Lieutenant Quibble. You can go away for a long while. Take a trip or something. So you're the regimental commander?
Yes, ma'am.
Don't call me ma'am. Call me General.
Yes, General.
Poor boys, you aren't allowed mustaches? Not that I like them very much, but it's the principle of the thing.
Yes, ma'am.
And no horses?
No horses.
Oh, one of man's greatest dumb friends.
Yes, ma'am, and no wife.
And no wife? That's not only a pity, but a shame.
That's what we think of it, ma'am. Of course, we could do without the horses and the mustache for a while, but...
You'd like a wife.
I certainly would.
Very well, it is decided. Wednesday is West Point's wedding day.
Yay, wedding day!
That's an order. Oh, regimental commander?
Yes, General?
Do you have a bride?
Not around handy, General.
With everybody married, I'll need a husband.
I'm only a cadet, General, but, would I do?
Well, I'm a semi-engaged to Lieutenant Quibble, but I've sort of lost interest in him.
If you'll pardon my temerity, General, I think you should have a husband in whom you are interested.
Right. And you get the appointment for the good of the Academy. That's an order.
Yay, Quibble! I shall obey your orders with the greatest of pleasure, General.
This film is nominated for an Academy Award for Best Picture. On December 4th, Jeanette MacDonald puts her hand and footprints in the sidewalk at Grauman's Chinese Theater.
On December 10th, Alice stars in 365 Nights in Hollywood.
I'd love to say yes to you.
You know all the words now?
I think so.
Well, let's try it right through. What's your high note?
I don't know.
I'd say C, maybe B flat, don't you think? Possibly A major.
Yeah. What key do you sing in?
I don't know that either.
She does sing, doesn't she?
Try it in F, Dick.
How I'd love to say yes to you. Oh, my
love to confess to you.
Oh. I'm sorry. Let's try it again. This time, put a little life in it. Give it a little... Push.
How I'd love to say yes.
No, you're not putting anything into it.
Oh, Jimmy, let's call it a day. We've been at this for hours.
When I get it right, I'll quit. Now look, honey, when you sing the first line, sock it a bit. Oh, how I'd love to say yes to you. Now go ahead. Dick.
How I'd love to say yes.
No. Can't you get it through your head? Sing it as though the lyrics meant something.
Oh, I guess I'm a little tired.
Well, do you think it's been any pleasure for me sweating around here for hours trying to teach a number to a dumb...
I don't think you should be so harsh with Miss Perkins. After all, she's an artist.
Then you rehearse it.
Miss Perkins, what Mr. Dale means is when you say yes, you gotta say yes. You know, yes.
Yes. Now listen, I don't care anything about your feelings. You're just a voice. All I want from you is one thing. I want this song sung the best way it can possibly be sung. Now, if you don't want to do it and you don't want to work on it, you better go back to Peoria.
I will.
Come here. If you're going to work for me, you better get used to this kind of treatment. I'm only doing this because I think you have something in there and I'm trying to drag it out.
Mr. Dale, don't you think it's...
No! Now, come on, do the chorus again. Dick.
How I'd love to say yes.
No! Can't you remember anything I tell you?
Yes, I remember.
Then why don't you do it?
All right.
Now, come on, do it from the beginning.
Here we stand within reach of happiness. You and I, both passing it by. Is it only because we can't express what we feel? It's hard to conceal. How I'd love to say yes to you. All my love to confess to you. My intuition seems to tell me that fate has opened the gate. So why should I wait?